all are safe, all are good. Once again, I want to say about SMS. Wear gloves, means wear mask, gloves and mask, and maintain social distance, and use sanitizer and wash your hands regularly. Okay? What we discussed in the previous sessions, I hope already remember that one. Properties. Properties we discussed, no? In rational numbers, what are that? Closure property and commutative property under four mathematical operations. What is meant by closure property? If you add any two natural numbers, the sum become a natural number. Like that, closure property under addition this is. Subtraction, you have to subtract it. For multiplication, you have to multiply, and the product is also a become natural number. Okay? Then, commutative property. If you change the order, that is A plus B is equal to B plus A. In commutative property under addition, A plus B is equal to B plus A. If you change the order of any two rational numbers, it become a rational number, and both sides the answer is same. That we learn. Now, third property is associative property under four mathematical operations. Okay, here associative property. Associative property under addition, under subtraction, and multiplication, and division. Multiplication and division. Okay, we'll see. First, we'll take the which set ma? Natural numbers. Natural numbers will apply the associative property. Okay, for natural numbers. For natural numbers, we'll apply the associative property under addition. So, what is mean by associative property? A plus B, put in a bracket, plus C is equal to A plus B plus C should be in the bracket. A plus B plus C. Okay. Now, if you do like this, both sides you have to get the same answer. First, I want to take the set of natural numbers. So, say any three natural numbers here. 2 plus 4 plus 3 plus 3 is equal to 2 plus 4 plus 3. Okay. Now, 2 plus 4, 6 plus 3 is equal to 2 plus, in bracket, 4 plus 3 is there. No, that you have to add first. 4 plus 3 is 7. Now, 6 plus 3, 9 is equal to 2 plus 7, 9. So, both sides you are getting same property, same answer, no? So, associative property under addition in natural numbers, it is closed or it is satisfied. You can write, therefore, it is closed. So, associative property under addition in set of natural numbers, it is closed or satisfied. Now, we'll see in subtraction what will happen. In subtraction, same. In place of plus, you have to take minus. A minus B minus of C is equal to A minus B minus C. A minus B minus C. B minus C. Okay? Now, take another three numbers. 3 minus 4 minus 5 is equal to 3 minus of 4 minus 5. Okay? First two numbers are in bracket. Then in right hand side, last two numbers are in bracket. Now, 3 minus 4, how much you will get, ma? Minus 1. This is minus, that's why you put in a bracket first. Now minus 5 is equal to 3 minus 4 minus 1. Minus 4 minus 5. How much you will get? Minus 1. Again, put in a bracket. Now, open the bracket means what I said? Before opening the bracket, you have to see the sign. So, here before the bracket, plus is there. Plus into minus. Minus. Minus 1, here minus 5 is equal to 3 minus into minus. Plus 1. Now, minus 1 minus 5 become minus 6. Minus 1 minus 5 become minus 6. Here 3 plus 1 4. Both sides you are getting same answer. No. So that's why associative property under subtraction in set of natural numbers, it is not closed. So it is not satisfied. Therefore it is not closed. Both sides you are getting the same answer. You can write it is closed or it is satisfied. But you are getting different answers to both sides. That's why it is not satisfied. Okay. Under addition, under subtraction we saw. Now under multiplication. Now understood no? Now multiplication we will see. Multiplication and division we will see. So under multiplication, what we can write now? A into B into C is equal to A into B into C. This is multiplication, that's why into B. Now take any three natural numbers. 5 into 6 into 7 is equal to 5 into 6 into 7. Okay. Now, first you multiply in bracket. First bracket numbers. 5, 6 are 30 into 7 is equal to 5 into 6, 7 are 42. Now, 30 into, now afterwards multiply these two. 37 are 7 zeros are 0, 7 threes are 21, 210. Now, 42 you have to multiply by 5. 5 2s are 10, 1 carry. 5 4s are 20 plus 1, 21. Both sides you are getting same answer, no? So it is closed under multiplication. So associative property under multiplication in set of natural numbers, it is closed. Therefore, it is closed. Or you can write it is satisfied. Now see the division. Division, it will be closed or not. Under division. Division means A divided by B. First you put in a bracket. Divided by C is equal to A divided by B divided by C. Okay. Now, I want to take 4 divided by 2 divided by 1 is equal to 4 divided by 2 divided by 1. Okay. First two numbers are in bracket. Here last two numbers are in bracket. Now 4 divided by 2. What the answer you will get? In 2 table how many times 4 will come? 2 times. So 2. This answer 2 divided by 1 is equal to. This 4 you keep like this only. Now divide symbol also like that only. Now divide this first in the bracket. In one table, 2 should be divided by 1. In one table, how many times 2 will come? 2. Okay. So, in one table, 2 will come 2 times. 1, 2 is 2. Now, here, in one table, this 2 will come in one table 2 times. 2 divided by 1, that is 2. Here 4 divided by 2. In 2 table how many times 2 will come? 2 times. So both sides you are getting same. Huh? sometimes only it will be happens, sometimes it will not happen, equally you won't get. Understood? Okay, some another example will take. Suppose say 4 divided by 2 divided by 3, if I take, then 4 divided by 2 divided by 3. See, 4 divided by 2, 2 you get it. Divided by 3 is equal to 4 divided by 3 divided by 2. In 3 table, how many times 2 will come? It will not come. So you will get the decimal answer. See, like this. In 3 table, 2 will come up. No. So, put decimal here. Add 0. 20. 3, 6 are 18. Again 26 is 66, so on. So one decimal will take 0.6. Now here again in 2 divided by 3 only, no. So already we did here. How much we got? 0.666, so on. So take 0.6 only. Now here 4 divided by 0.6. So how can you do this one? 4 divided by 0.6. 4, when this is in decimal, change into a fraction. Now 4 into 10 by 6, that is when the division is changed into multiplication, you have to take the reciprocal. Now 2 3s are 2 2s are, that is 20 by 3 you are getting. So 20 by 3 means in 3 table how many times 20 will come? 3 6 are 18. Again 2 will be left, 20, again 6.333, so on you are getting. So you are getting the same answer on both sides? No. So it is not closed under. So see here, sometimes it will be equal answer you are getting, sometimes you are not getting, always you won't get it, sometimes it will be get. Means on the whole you have to write, it is not closed. It is not closed under addition. In closure property also I said, in closure property, in subtraction, in closure property what I said, for example, 5 minus 3 is 2 you are getting. Suppose 3 minus 5 you are getting, minus 2 you are getting, no? So according the taking of the numbers you are getting this. So it will be satisfied, it is not satisfied under natural numbers. So, on the whole, you have to write. Understood? So, on the whole, subtraction is not closure in natural numbers. So, similarly, here also, the division. So, associative property under division in natural numbers, it is not closed. Therefore, it is not closed. Okay, ma'am? Now, understood? So, associative property we applied for subtractions, for all mathematical operations. Now, additive identity and multiplicative identity. What is meant by additive identity? Which is additive identity already you learned in 7th class? 0. 0 is called additive identity. So, if you add 0 to any number, the answer becomes the number itself only, no? So, that's why 0 is called additive identity. AI. Simply we can say that AI. So what is AI? 0. Additive identity is 0. So example 2 plus 0. 2. 100 plus 0. 100. So to any number, if you add 0, you are getting the number itself only. That's why 0 is called additive identity. So now, multiplicative identity, MI. What is multiplicative identity? If you multiply any number by 1, you are getting the number itself. For example, 100. 100 into 1, 100. If you take 99 into 1, 99 only. So, any number if you multiply by 1, you are getting the number itself. That's why 1 is called multiplicative identity and 0 is called additive identity. under natural numbers I said the properties, no? Your homework is you have to apply associative property under integer, whole numbers and integers. Apply associative property for whole numbers and integers under four mathematical operations only. Two pages. In one page, how I make the table? Here whole numbers you have to write. Here addition, subtraction, multiplication, so division. Upper you have to write associative property. One page you will get. Then next page for integers, addition, subtraction, again four columns you have to make and you have to see whether it is closed or not. Okay, that is your homework. Okay, do it. Okay, have a nice day.